Good afternoon, one and all. I'll try to keep this not boring because, of course, I can see not everyone over here. So, starting with the talk for today, because I already have a very less time over here that has been given by the event organizers. Today, why am I here? The reason I'm here is because, of course, apart from that, these people called me that I wanted to always be among the young college students because it's always so much filled with energy, enthusiasm, and I like to be around the college life. Like right from when I was in college, I used to love this life apart from the school life or the working life that I have right now. And it's not like I'm too old from you guys. Still, I look like a college kid from my face. So, yeah, that's the reason I'm here, and I wanted to share my story that how amongst like the entrepreneurs that people have generally thought that they would be or they are, I wanted to share that what all things that I have been through and might have in the end, if you guys think that there's something learning worthwhile, that is the time when I'll feel that the talk was a satisfactory one. So going ahead, the topic of my talk is dreams come true. Now this is a fairy tale that, you know, everyone hears when you're a child that, you know, dreams do come true. But when you grow up, then, you know, in the Indian marketing industry, there's something that always comes up. Those are these tiny little devils that are there always. There's some problem with this, but can we get it fixed? Sorry to waste your time. Yeah. So in the end, you can see those two tiny devils that are there, which is written aside. I think so everyone knows what's this for. Those are called as terms and conditions. So dreams do come true, but of course there are terms and conditions with it. So now let us explore what is those terms and conditions, and this will be explained through a story of my life. So going ahead, this is the story of my life. Like I was an average student. Like I, of course, being from a Gujarati family, that I cannot afford to get less marks, because then your parents are not their judges, but then there is a society who will always judge you on how much marks you are getting in your school or your college life. And moreover than that, I had my brother who had set the bar too high because he was a topper at the school, and also he entered into IIT Bombay, which is a nightmare for me. So I was not that a topper, but I used to get a decent percentage. So I was an average student. Apart from that, in our family, we always had this little work that was always distributed to us, like either bringing bread from the market or going to the bank. So from that time, the childhood, I had this sense of ownership. And I wanted to do something on my own. And I thought that, you know, working under someone is not something that I would like to do. So with that thing, I thought that I'll start something of my own. And given the youth sector, which I like. So that was the second point that I didn't have in my life. And I was there to achieve something, because marks was not something that I could have achieved and not go to an IIT Bombay. So I had to show the world that I had to do something with it. So that's what was there. And then there's a formula X. Like how there was a ingredient X for Powerpuff Girls, similarly, there's a formula X in my story, which we'll talk about. So going ahead, you know, 5-6 years ago, the entrepreneurship market boomed up, and there were these Steve Jobs and Warren Buffett books coming out, and people used to write a lot of things and those taglines and punches. Now, when I was also in a college, I was very prepped up as an energized kid that I want to do something in my life. And I started reading these taglines, and I kept them, as you know, in big papers stuck in front of my cupboard so that I could read that every day and get motivated. But then I didn't know that these taglines would also come wrong. So there are these few punches that I read, which eventually I thought that they would be like that, but didn't turn out. So let us see what was those. Now this is a general college kid over here sitting, everyone. I can turn out that, you know, because of the less crowd, this is what happened yesterday. This is a general mindset of a normal college kid that, you know, Friday night, yes, let's complete my work of the week and then go for a party, get drunk, etc. But then, you know, when you have learned and when you have decided to do something on your own, you will end up doing this. So time and enjoyment is a luxury that you'll have to give up for some amount of time till the time your startup at least becomes at a level and you have a big enough team to work under you. And even if that comes, this will still happen, which I still do today. So this is something that was one of the mindset that changed, which I was going through the journey. This is another mindset, you know, that, oh, startups get funded very well. There are so many VCs sitting out there. And, you know, they're just going to shower some $1 million or $500,000 to you. You go and pitch to them. And you are going to them with so much of prepped energy, enthusiasm, and sorry, but that's what we're going to have. You're going to be filled with that because your wallets are not going to be full. And you'll have to travel in rickshaws to go and pitch to these VCs. So have this mindset ready, because that's going to be requiring some patience. You may get funded, very well for you. I'll be clapping my hands when you get it. But for those who don't get it, you know, after every 1 in 100 businesses get funded. So you don't have to lose hope over there. This is something that, you know, I dreamt of that, you know, I had seen offices of Google, Facebook, and I thought that I will keep my office something like that. Well, I have a foosball table, a TT table, and people will come and work around here. And in the end, this is where I start working on. Not because Starbucks is cool or the coffee is really nice. Just because you have a high-speed internet over there. So, this is what's going to happen for some time, because you cannot sit at home and work, because then your parents will feel that you are already wasting time in your college by sitting home. And again, now by working, you are doing the same thing. So, you need to get out and work from a cafe. So, therefore, Starbucks. So, you know, but this is not over here, that I'm not demotivating all the entrepreneurs, the few ones who have come here. But entrepreneurship in itself is a difficult title. The difficulty starts with the spelling. I misspelled it so many times. So, but the journey that comes along is a difficult one. You need to go around a lot of hardships to achieve that what you had in mind. And what is required is a lot of patience, a lot of endurance, so that you still stick there where you had planned, and slowly there will be a light at the end of the tunnel which you will get, but that path may be difficult. And therefore, the two pointers which I told, the two devils that are there, what were those? Terms and conditions. So those terms and conditions, terms and conditions that will be applied, which will be for me, something may be different for you. But out of my journey, I picked up two terms and conditions which are very apt and were coming up to me every time, and because of which I felt a lot of failures over the time. So this is what I'm going to discuss, also because I have a time constraint of 10 minutes, so I cannot go on talking as well. So the first terms and condition that we have is, don't overthink. We have been hearing and reading these lines where people say, don't think, just do it. The problem over there is that when you're doing your own business, you're not the single person that is going to be affected with the consequence of a decision that you will take. You have your family, you have your stakeholders, you have your team, and every consumer who is going to be relying on that decision that you take. And that's the reason why you need to think a little bit. At the same time, you cannot overthink. You know, how much ever you plan, how much ever backup resources you will keep, but in the end, it's not going to always turn up as you had planned. So as someone has said, you know, life happens amongst where you were planning other things. And you don't require a plan always to do the things that you had thought in your mind. So think a little bit about what you want to do and start doing those things. At the same time, if you don't, if you waste your time thinking a lot, there are 100 other people who are going to do the same thing, and then you will be lost in the race. As we had seen in the favorite movie, I think, so that life is a race. From the childhood, we are doing that. So that's the first terms and condition that we need to do. This picture is an interesting one. Now, we all know who this guy will be, right? Is there anyone who doesn't know who this guy is? Okay, so people who don't know, this guy is Richard Branson, who is the founder of Virgin Group. And there was an interesting story, an incident that happened, which is there shown in the picture, is that there was one day, the accountant, they had kept a party at some beach, and one of the accountants went up to Richard, and he said that, you know, today we got a new project, and which we are going to get 100 times $10,000. So Richard started doing some counting on his fingers, and he was murmuring some numbers like, what is 100 times 10,000? Now this accountant was shocked, knowing that a founder of such a multi-billionaire company, and he doesn't know to do basic maths, like 100 times 10,000 is $1 million. It's so simple. So then Richard saw this question mark on his face. So therefore he told him that, I know what you're thinking, that me being a CEO, I don't do basic maths, But he told you that I have always focused on one thing, which is my incoming is always more than my outgoing. And that is the only principle you need to have at any point of time, because that's what's going to make you last. And again, coming from a Gujarati family, we had this principle that if you want to do a dhanda, you need to have 6 months of fun to sustain your business. Otherwise, your business is not going to grow and you'll have bad times, which you or I cannot control. So, these are two specific terms and conditions which a lot of people will face or would already be facing when they are doing their business or would be planning to start the company. So always remember about these two things which I learned really late. And if I'm glad if you guys have still started or you have time, you can incorporate these things in your journey. Going ahead, so coming for the final secret ingredient, my formula X. So for that, here's what I say, one is the right people. Because in a startup or in a company, you know, people, you don't have money, you don't have resources to waste. So you need to have people who are going to be sticking through you with the bad times that are going to come or the good times. And it's very difficult to find those trustworthy people who want to be by your side for every decision that you'll be taking together as a team. So the first important point is the right people. With that, little thinking. Because as I told you, that little thinking is something that you'll have to put in and not overthinking that you'll have to put in the decisions that you make. And finally, is more patience. This is something that is very, very much required when you're doing your own business. Because there'll be times when you think that, you know, my friends are going for a vacation to Bahamas, my friend is then getting awards over other jobs that he's doing, and what am I doing over here? Going to Starbucks and working. But, you know, there's patience, but this is one thing that is good for me. Like being a Mumbaikar boy, we have had rejections since childhood. Not for girls, fortunately, but from our grateful rickshawalas. So you always have seen that a boy gets rejected by a rickshawala at least 3 to 4 times before he gets a rickshaw. And that's not it. The situation worsens. When you see a girl, she gets a rickshaw at the same time for the same location when the boy doesn't get. So luckily for this thing, I was trained. But apart from the jokes, yes, patience is something that you'll have to endure a lot when you're going to be coming and starting your own business, which I still have. Still today, I need to keep patient with the team who is not working properly, or that hard times when there are the problems in, say, finances, or there are problems in the work that we do. So, but if you keep a right combination of these three things while you're doing your business, that's where you're going to have a eureka moment. And in the end, there'll be light towards your tunnel. So that is what I had as my experience. And when that happens, you know, of course, you might not have a very funky office like a Google. But then, yeah, I had something of my own, which I was proud to show off. And I could tell that is something that I have done. And that is a time when, you know, I got called for a talk. That's the reason I'm here. And tomorrow, that might be the reason you guys are there as well. So you need to understand, and not just have a desk which is full of workloads from your boss. It'll be very good to have that feeling when you have people working under you with your office and you have decorated in the way that you want. So that's what is the experience and the story about. Towards the end, what I would conclude it is this line that I've always have had in my mind during the entire time of my journey, that, you know, a revolution starts with a small promise. Small fact, but with a big promise. The small fact is the solution that you're trying to provide to the problem that is there in the industry. But there's always a big promise out there that this is something that I'll solve and this is where I'll take my company. And with significant force, that becomes a big significant force in the market. But that requires endurance, that requires patience, that requires the right people. So if you are looking to start out tomorrow, it's good that you will, and I wish all of them a very good luck for that as well. But you need to know that that journey is not going to be easy. But at the end of this, when you will be on this stage and I'll be sitting in the crowd, you will feel that the journey that you had, in the end, you'll have a satisfaction when you do this. And that's the reason today when, say, I meet people or I'm out, people are applauding for me or I get awards, I feel that what I did, not the money that I made from my business, which of course happened, otherwise I would have not been here as well. So, but that is a real satisfaction that you guys will get when you have done something on your own. And this is what I would like to share with everyone. And towards the end, while I'm ending my talk over here, I'll just give you one thought for food, that what is your formula X that you're going to apply in your business or the entrepreneurship journey that you're going to take forward? Because every dream will have a formula X, which may be some points from my, but it'll be based on the situations that you guys will have. So that's what I'm going to be ending my topic with. And I hope you guys had some time and I didn't bore you for sitting over here. So, yeah.